expectation. Number literacy is where we all excel in school very well. As of today, I'm proud to say so many Indian students are known worldwide to do brilliant calculations. But what we really need to enhance ourselves is the interpretation as to what does that answer really mean. Whatever calculation you do, what does it really mean at the end of the day? If you find out an average of a particular number, what does the answer really mean?
In big pandals or temples needs massive calculations so that everything works smoothly, with one being the amount of paint needed to cover the body of Lord Ganesha. This is calculated using the formula of surface area, which is the average estimation of the area of the shape in meters. Then you convert the area into square feet and then convert it into liters. Furthermore, estimation is used to make food or prasadam in the puja of the festival. Data handling is also used in the festival. The stats of the last few years help pandals to prepare food according to the crowd. Besides that, the temples have to have a good waiting arrangement because pandals like Lal Bagcha Raja have around 1.5 million people coming there, and in span of only 10 days. And the average waiting time to watch the humongous idol is 3 to 4 hours. For that, geometry comes to the rescue. Also, mathematics is used for the expense management of the Pandal Trust. The money collected from the donations minus the amount of money spent on these expenses equals the profit or the loss for the Pandal Trust. Additionally, measurements is used to see how much water is needed for the immersion of the idol of Lord Ganesha at minimum.
On the last day, Uttar Puja is performed, after which idol is carried for immersion, and we decide the location based on the number of people and the depth of water, that is the volume. Thus, I was wrong that there is no correlation between mass and Ganesh Chaturthi. And in the end, I say everything which is going around us is somehow related to mass.
Sahil said that the amount of water required for the emulsion of the idol also comes in another category of mathematics. So I did not understand that point.
So usually, I think I will explain this. Oh, let Sahil take it. Go ahead.
Okay. So basically, what I meant was the minimum amount of water needed to fully immerse the Ganesha idol, no? So that is why you need a little bit amount of measurement so that the whole idol is immersed. So that is why you need mathematics for that. That's what I meant.
Actually. Interesting. Yeah, so basically it's a water body, right? So is there enough water to accommodate the idol or no? If it's a big idol, if it's a big idol, then is the pond small? Then it won't make sense, right? Okay.
All know is the glorious festival of light that entails sparkling fireworks, colorful rangolis, glowing lights, and vibrant rituals. But the point is that what do Mats and Diwali have in common? Let's start from the basic. Diwali falls on different dates every year based on the Hindu mythological calendar owing to the position of moon in the solar system. Also, the basic Diwali expenditure, whatever we purchase in Diwali, be it ornaments, gadgets, basic puja items, home decor or even sweets, everything has to be properly planned and squandered upon. We have to calculate the balance, our savings and expenditure in Diwali. Also, there are certain businesses that face huge profits and even losses during Diwali. Businesses like that of sweets, firecrackers and home decor face excessive gains, while certain businesses stoop low. Also, in Diwali preparations, when we prepare sweets, everything has to be taken in fixed proportions in order to make a perfect sweet. Also, my best loved thing in Diwali, making rangolis, also has a certain connection to maths. The shapes and appearance of the rangoli shows mathematical figures like circles, squares, ovals, etc. Thus, proof that maths is limitless and is even connected to Diwali. Thank you.
Use number system to calculate the number of garlands and the number of diyas required to decorate the house. Then, potters also use ratio and proportion so as to make diyas, as it requires equal in proportion of mud and water. They also use the understanding of shapes to make diyas. We also use direct variation in Diwali. Don't know how? Let me tell you. If the number of servants in a home is more, then the number of sweet boxes to be utilized will be more. And if the number of sweets are less, then the number of servants are less. This is how we use direct variation in Diwali. We also use measurements to measure the length and breadth of garlands as we offer them to the gods and the goddesses.
In West Bengal, the idol is placed in a well-decorated pandal. These decorations involve different architectural concepts, and the mere mention of the word architecture implies the use of measurement and many formulas that are derived through mathematics. It also includes trigonometry to a large extent.
The significance of the Durga Puja has not been less. Thank you.
Okay, I have to say this was the only response that exactly ended at dot 4 minutes. So I think that is another way of estimating how much time we actually use. Well done, DPS Vasati. I think everyone should give a round of applause as well. Show some excitement for them too. For you to say one word or one line, we'll start with Pari Agarwal.
According to me, we debated on this session because everyone learned that mathematics is not just in notebooks, it is everywhere in the world.
Okay, that's interesting. Parnab, what do you would like to say? What was your key takeaway in today's session?
Sir, I think we have learned a lot of information that mathematics are used in everything in the whole world. Math is used. We cannot say anything without math.
Very good. Great. Let's go to Ayushi.
Yes, sir. Sir, I think this whole debate brought us to a conclusion that everything that happens, even our festivals, has a connection. Even our festivals has a connection with maths. And I think every festival that was brought out today, every festival had things and points in common. And it also relates us that maths is something that has to be in everything that happens.
Interesting. Very good. Let's go to next part. We'll go to Sahil.
Sir, I think we had this debate because we are trying to uncover the new world of maths. We are trying to discover something new from maths, something that we haven't researched before. Something like the real life application of mathematics.
Interesting. Yeah. That's great. Can we go to Kaushal?
Yes, sir. I think that many people in the world just study maths and do not understand its applications. So I think this event, this debate helped the people to understand the real life applications of maths, and that we cannot stand without maths. There's nothing in the world except maths, and everything is dependent on maths. Thank you.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Let's go to Arnav now. Arnav, what did you, why do you think we had this whole maths debate in the first place?
We had this debate to correlate the importance of maths with festivals.